I feel better now.
Good, because I don't want you to worry about anything, all right? Nothing is going to stop us from getting married.
If you say so, I believe you. I don't know why I was feeling that negative energy in the air, but Miguel, I trust you.
Charity, Everything is going to be fine, all right? I promise you that. We're going to get married, and we're going to have a wonderful life together. What is it?
Miguel, what? This horrible chill just ran through my body. I'm sorry, but you're wrong. Something terrible is going to happen tonight. And I just hope and pray it's not to us. So, David, I don't think you ever quite answered me. How was your friend, Ivy Gray?
Kay, what are you talking about? Ivy and David are not friends.
Oh. Really?
Yes, really. Now, why would you think that?
You know, I'm sick and tired of being threatened by you, Ivy.
It's not a threat, David. Won't everyone be surprised when they find out that you're not married to Grace and that John isn't Grace's son and that you lied about the whole thing?
Liz, come on. Now, you said that you identify your sister at the party. Now, who is she?
Are you sure you want to know, TC?
Naturally, I'm curious. You told us what a horrible person that she was and that she lives here in Harmony. And I want to make sure I keep her away from my family.
TC, once I tell you, it's going to change everything.
Liz, what do you mean?
Once I tell you who my sister is, you'll understand. But if you really want me to tell you, I will.
So what is the little chalupa up to now?
I don't know, but she certainly is tenacious, isn't she?
Well, she's too late. There is no way that she can ruin Ethan and Gwen's wedding tomorrow.
No, I certainly hope not.
Why don't we forget all about the little lying tramp and celebrate our children's happiness? Here, here. To Ethan and Gwen, may they be happily married for the rest of their lives. Yes. And to the new baby. And to their new lives in Alaska, where they will be thousands and thousands of miles away from the scheming Teresa Lopez Fitzgerald.
I'll drink to that. There's nothing she can do about it now. Right?
Right.
Teresa, what do you want?
Oh, I have to talk to you. To both of you. It's very important. Ethan still hasn't told Gwen that he's accepted the job working at Crane Industries. Maybe he's gonna tell her while they're dancing together. And ruin the party for Gwen. No. No, he's gonna wait till they get home, but by then it's gonna be too late. Because once those papers arrive, I'm gonna pretend that I had no idea that he hadn't told her. Gwen will think that Ethan's been keeping secrets from her, and she's gonna go ballistic. Whitney, everything is working out perfectly. Gwen will call off the wedding, and Ethan will finally be mine.
What's this about, Teresa?
You know what I'm saying is true. If Antonio takes the big dirt nap before the wedding, Luis is gonna dump you for Sheridan in a flash.
No, Mother. None of what you say will happen because Antonio will marry Sheridan. And I will marry Luis.
But you open your eyes. Look at Antonio. He is a dead man walking.
You know, I think all this dancing's made me thirsty.
You okay?
Yeah, I've never felt better.
toe-tag time for Antonio and the end of your time with Luis.
Antonio, please, God, don't let this be the end, please.
He's not breathing. Antonio's not breathing.
All right, up to the ace. 200. I call. Raise. 400. All right, Fox, up to you. I'll raise 800. I'm out.
Too rich for my blood.
Raise again. 1,200. Call. Four ladies. Sir? Straight flush.
You're a lucky guy, handsome.
It's amazing. How can someone be four queens?
Well, it looks like our young friend here just has. Thank you, sir. Another hand?
He's not breathing. Somebody get Dr. Russell.
My God, he's dead. Please, no.
I'll get Dr. Russell.
Come on, Liz. Who is she?
Dr. Russell, come quick. Antonio's collapsed.
Antonio?
Teresa, what is going on?
Ethan, I'm sure whatever it is, it can wait.
No, I'm afraid that it can't wait. Hank, what's going on?
Teresa, your brother collapsed.
Oh, my God, Antonio.
Charity, what is it? What terrible thing do you think's gonna happen?
I don't know, but something's happening right now. Look!
Oh, my God, it's my brother.
Your mother asked you a question, Kay. Now, what makes you think David and Ivy are friends?
They hardly know each other.
Really? You know what? Why don't you ask David? Because I think he knows Ivy a little bit more than he's letting on.
Sam, Antonio collapsed.
What?
I called an ambulance, but it may take a while to get here. There's a fire about 10 miles outside of town. Listen, do you still have that oxygen in your patrol car?
Yes, where is he?
He's in the bar.
Sam's brother said Antonio collapsed.
What a way to ruin a party. You know, it's always something with that family. Maybe we should go. Maybe there's something we can do. Oh, you're right. Ooh. I wonder if Antonio needs to have his shirt taken off. What are you doing?
Kay knows.
What? Knows what?
Kay knows that I'm working for you.
Oh, that's impossible. How would she know?
I don't know how, but she knows.
Well, then why hasn't she said anything to Sam and Grace?
I don't know. But she's a devious little girl. And I don't trust a thing she does.
Oh, I will not let that little twit ruin everything. I have finally driven a wedge between Sam and Grace to the point where they're not even sleeping in the same bed. Okay, you just go on doing what I pay you to do. If Kay knows anything, take care of her. What happened?
Get it.
We were dancing and then he staggered and he fell. I thought he fainted, but Luis says he's not breathing.
I couldn't get a pulse.
I'm afraid that he's... Eve, please, can you help my son? Please help him.
Thank you. with you. Please tell me my son's gonna be okay, please.
I've got a pulse.
Thank God.
He's breathing.
He's gonna be okay. Okay.
Sonny.
What happened?
You lost consciousness. How do you feel?
Tired.
Any pain? Any headache?
Yeah, I have a mother of a headache.
Okay, well, let me get you to the hospital where I can monitor
you.
No,
no hospital. I just want to go home.
Antonio, your condition is very serious.
Eve, please, if I'm dying, I want to be at home. I don't want to die in a hospital, okay?
TC, Sam, would you get him up? Yeah, he wants to
sure.
go home.
Easy. Come on, buddy. Easy. All right, this way.
Come on. Everybody clear out.
Dr. Russell, what's going on?
He's getting worse, isn't he? I'm afraid so, Sharon. His condition's deteriorating much more quickly than I thought it would, and he doesn't have much more time.
No. Not yet. Please, not yet.
Too bad, Bethy. Your dream wedding was just that, a dream. Antonio is gonna die, and you are gonna get the old dumperoo.
Premonition was about? What's happening to my brother Antonio?
I don't think so. Because I'm still sensing that something really bad is going to happen. Miguel, it's terrible.
What is, Charity?
There are people here in this place that just want to cause unhappiness. They want to destroy love. They want to tear apart relationships.
What people? What people are you talking about?
I don't know, because the faces, the images, they came so quickly. But I'm sensing their emotions so strongly, Miguel, and they want to ruin love. They want to tear apart marriages. Stop weddings.
Teresa, is Antonio okay?
I mean, I don't know. They took him home.
But not to the hospital.
Mm-mm. He didn't want to go there.
I think I'm gonna go see if I can help. I'll be right back.
Okay. I guess you didn't get a chance to tell Gwen the news about Ethan taking the job.
No, I was about to give her the envelope when Hank ran up and he told us about Antonio.
Well, actually, I think that that's a lucky break for you.
What do you mean, lucky?
I mean, you were gonna pretend like you thought Ethan had already told Gwen about the job, right? And then you were gonna spring the envelope on her, and she was gonna get mad and say that she was gonna call off the wedding.
Yeah? So?
Ethan's not that stupid. He's gonna know that you were up to something, Teresa. He'll know that you were deliberately trying to get Gwen mad. And guess who he's gonna be mad at then?
You're right, Whitney. I cannot give Gwen this envelope.
Good. Good, Teresa. I'm so glad that you're not going to go through with this. Look, I know that you love Ethan, but it's just not right to try to break up Ethan and Gwen right before their wedding.
Whitney, I am not giving up getting Ethan back. I have every intention to make sure that their wedding does not happen. I've just got to find another way to do it.
Ace high flush. Beats my straight. Thank you, sir. I appreciate it. I'm going to take a break. Have a cigar, okay with you? Be my guest. I'm not going anywhere.
Can I get you anything else, sir?
Yes, actually, you can get the lovely ladies whatever they're having. Here's a little something for you.
Thanks, sir.
I guess this takes that cutie Ethan out of circulation.
This should be the biggest wedding in Harmony.
Harmony?
Could you imagine marrying into all the Crane billions?
Yeah, but Ethan's not a Crane, remember? He was disinherited.
Breaks my heart to think about it. Having that all and then losing it.
The poor guy must have been devastated.
I know that look in your eye, Teresa. What kind of plan are you hatching now? Well, I just thought of another way to get Gwen these papers and not have my fingerprints on it. Trust me, Whitney, this one's gonna work. When Gwen finds out that Ethan took that job with me and he didn't tell her, she's gonna blow sky high.
Hey.
How's Antonio?
Not good. He collapsed again when we got him into the car.
Laura, I feel so bad for her family.
Yeah, me too. Hey, where's Kay? I want to talk to her about what she was saying about David.
I don't know where Kay went.
Well, I want to find her. You know, maybe she knows something about David that we don't.
Sam, what can she possibly know that we don't know about
David?
Well,
that's what I want to find out. You know, I've always been suspicious of David.
Yeah.
It's hard living a secret, Sam.
Well, I never meant it to be David. I'm just curious to find out what Kay may know about you.
There's nothing to know.
Look, Sam, you're just grasping at straws here. I mean, you're looking for anything you possibly can find that's bad about David.
Well, the truth never hurts anyone, does it? I just want to find out what Kay meant.
Going to blow David and Ivy out of the water. And once I do that, Mother will be so worried about her own problems, she won't have time to think about me going after Miguel. Hello, Mrs. Crane.
Kay. I think we need to have a little talk.
Oh, really?
Yes, really. Look, I don't know what you think you know.
Oh, I know a lot, Mrs. Crane.
Well, whatever. I'm just going to give you a friendly little warning. If you play in the big leagues, little girl, you might get hurt.
Ooh. I guess we'll just see about that.
Listen to me, okay? If you play with fire, you will get burnt.
You know, Kay, I hear that you and your mother aren't getting along very well, that you're constantly at each other's throats. Why don't you think about this? I might be your stepmother someday.
Now, wouldn't you really rather have me as a friend than an enemy?
You will never be my stepmother.
Oh, don't count me out, dear.
Now, you're a smart little girl.
Why don't you be smart about this?
I'll do what I want, Mrs. Crane.
I think we all should just go home and get some rest because there is nothing more we can do for Antonio tonight.
How long does my son have, Eve?
I can't tell, Pilar. But I can tell you that he is deteriorating more quickly than I thought he would.
So you're saying the end could come soon?
He doesn't have much longer, Pilar. Of course, Pilar. You know you can call me at any hour if you need me.
Thank you, Eve.
Good. But he'll sleep for a while now. Sheridan, I'm sorry. Come on, this isn't easy for any of us, okay?
No, it isn't. I'm gonna go get some air.
Anyway. I think I'll take Sheridan her tea.
Yeah, honey, you do that.
Hey. Thought you might want your tea.
Thank you. Louise, wait. I want to talk to you.
About what?
You heard Eve. Antonio's getting worse.
Yeah, I heard Eve.
You saw what happened tonight. Luisi's dying.
We've known he's been dying for months now, Sheridan.
Right, but now... now it's really happening. Luis, what if... Antonio dies before we get married? But God knows... I don't want him to die, but it could happen.
It could happen.
What would it mean for us? If Antonio dies before we marry, are you still going to marry Beth? Or would you come back to me?
Oh, get ready, Bethy. Because you're about to find out that Louise has no desire to marry you. None at all.
Louise, tell me, please. If Antonio dies before we get married, are you still going to go through with marrying Beth?
Jerry, sit down, okay? You got to try to calm down.
Miguel, I'm having such a strong feeling right now. About all these people, I don't know why they would be doing it.
I wish you could tell me who you're seeing.
I know, I mean, the faces, they're all blurred. I can't... No, wait. I saw Liz and Teresa and Beth and her mom, but that doesn't make any sense.
Not if you think that they're determined to break up marriages and relationships.
I know. I mean... Teresa still loves Ethan, but she's not evil. She's not going to break up Ethan and Gwen. And Liz seems like a really nice person, so...
She doesn't even know anybody in Harmony except Luis and Sheridan, so who could she possibly want to separate?
I don't know. Beth, she's marrying Luis. She's happy. Why would I be seeing these things? What does it all mean? Oh, no.
What is it? What?
Miguel... I just saw another face, another person who wants to destroy relationships. It was Kay. I think she wants to tear us apart, Miguel. She wants to stop our wedding.
Okay, there you are.
What's up, Dad?
I want to know what you were talking about earlier. You seem to think that David and I were friends. Now, do you know something about them that you're not telling us?
Liz, I know this is hard for you.
Yeah. It's hard to see him like this, TC. I'll always love him. I just hate to see him going through this.
Let's give Pilar some time alone with her son.
Hey, sweetheart, how you doing?
I'm okay. I'm just writing instructions to Sheridan to take care of Antonio. And then we can go, because he's probably going to sleep through the night.
Well, honey, I'm not in the mood to go back to the party, are you?
No, not at all.
That reminds me, Liz, your sister was supposed to show up at the party. Did she ever show up?
I'm not sure.
Well, I guess with everything going on tonight, it would be easy to miss her. But why don't you just tell us her name?
Your dream wedding is about to turn into a nightmare, Missy. You're gonna get dumped before you say I do.
I don't want you to answer me right away. Because I want you to think about it. I want you to think about what all this really means. You and I love each other very much. We planned on getting married, spending the rest of our lives together, but all of this happened with Antonio, and things got so complicated.
Look, Sheridan, you don't have to tell me about everything that happened, okay? I lived it, remember?
I know, I'm sorry. I just want you to know that my feelings for you have never changed. All right, I never stopped loving you. I love you now more than ever. I just hope that you still love me. I want us to have our dream, and we might have that chance now. That's why I need to know how you feel. Do you still want to marry me? Or are you going to go through with marrying Beth?
Charity, are you sure that it was Kay?
Yes, Miguel. She wants to stop the wedding.
Oh, okay. Well, look, don't get upset about this, all right? There could be a lot of other ways to interpret your premonition.
I don't know, Miguel. But you're right. There must be an explanation because I don't know why Kay would want to get in between us.
So now, me giving myself to you, instead of it being the beautiful thing that it should be, it's now your dirty little secret. Well, that makes me feel a lot better, Miguel.
I'm so sorry, Kay. All right, I never meant to hurt you.
Well, you did, Miguel. You've hurt me more than I've ever been hurt in my entire life.
I don't know why I'm having these feelings, Miguel, but I feel so strongly that Kay or somebody wants to tear us apart. So just tell me that there's no way that anybody can get in between us.
Kay? Now, do you know something about David you're not telling us?
So, what is it, Kay? What do you mean when you say Ivy is David's friend?
What are you up to, Kay?
I didn't mean anything. I don't know why I said what I said.
Are you sure? And why did you ask David about his friend, Ivy?
I just meant that I knew. David was working for Ivy at the New Year's party last year, and I was wondering if he was possibly going to work for her again at Ethan's wedding. That's it.
Are you sure?
Yes, Daddy. I'm sure.
You see, Sam, I told you it wasn't anything.
I wish I could kiss you.
You can't. Simone's around here somewhere.
Let's go find a place that's a little less public.
I had the contracts department put a rush in your paperwork so that you can start your marriage feeling secure in your new job.
Thank you.
And I'm also giving you a long-term contract and benefits so that you don't have to worry about your future.
I appreciate everything you've done, Teresa, really.
Well, you're the one who's doing me a favor. You know I'm going to depend on you and your experience. We need you at Crane Industries.
I couldn't be happier.
Good. You'll get the documents sometime tomorrow.
Great. Just, please deliver them to me, not to Gwen. I haven't had the chance to tell her about the job.
Don't worry, Ethan. I'll deliver them to you, and only you.
Thanks for the drinks. Be right back.
Well, well, well.
What do you know?
Well, Fox, ready to try your luck again?
It's not a matter of luck. Skill. Do me in.
So you will make sure the contracts are delivered to me?
Yes, they will be delivered to you. I know that you want to tell Gwen about the job first.
Thank you. Thank you for everything.
You're welcome, Ethan. Mrs. Crane, I heard what you said to Mr. Winthrop. Why did you tell him the contract would be sent tomorrow? You have it right here.
Oh, fish. That's none of your concern, okay? I just want you to deliver this tomorrow, right before the wedding, to Gwen.
But Mr. Winthrop said specifically to send it to him, not to his fiancée.
You're going to make a little mistake.
Mrs. Crane, I don't...
Who do you work for, Trish?
You, of course. Whatever you say, I will deliver the papers to Gwen right before the wedding tomorrow.
Excellent. Thank you, Trish. We'll just see if that wedding really does take place. He's got to be around here somewhere. Come on, I'll help you look for him.
Charity, you have to try to relax. Okay, you're probably just having these premonitions because of all the stress and excitement of planning our wedding.
I hope you're right.
I am. I promise. Okay? Everything's gonna be fine. Nothing is gonna stop Ethan and Gwen's wedding tomorrow, and nothing's gonna stop ours.
Daddy, Mother, I don't know what you guys are thinking, okay? What could I possibly know about David that you don't?
Are you sure?
Positive.
I told you, Sam.
I guess I was just hoping that you did know something about David. I mean, this whole thing with David coming into our lives has been kind of a nightmare.
Daddy, I know. I'm sorry. If I did know something about David, I'd tell you, I swear. I love you so much.
I love you too.
Okay. A wise decision to keep your mouth shut, okay? I may have decided to keep it shut for now, Mrs. Crane, but I could change my mind at any time.
Laura, hi. Is Antonio...
He's asleep. I just want to make him some soup when he wakes up.
Yeah. Well, we'll get out of your way, okay, honey?
Thank you.
Liz, since you didn't see your sister at the party, why can't you tell us her name?
You know, TC, right now the time isn't correct. But I promise you, when the time is right, I will tell you who she is.
All right, Liz, I won't push. Sweetheart, you really look done in. You ready to go home?
Yeah, I think I'm pretty tired.
Liz, you want to ride with us?
Oh, no, thanks. TC, I think I, want to stay with Antonio for a while.
I'll get you back.
Thank you.
Lar, we're leaving now. Just call me if you need me.
Thank you, Eve.
Sweetheart, I'll bring the car around front. Good night, Mrs. Wallace.
Good night, TC.
Not yet. You have to hold on just a little longer. Just until Luis and I are married. You just can't die yet.
Luis, I want you to take your time answering me because this is just too important. And I know how this sounds. I don't want Antonio to die, but God is going to take him. It's in his hands. But it's in your hands whether you and I are together or not. You have to decide. If Antonio dies before we get married, are you still going to go through with marrying Beth? Or will you be with me? I just can't wait to marry Ethan.
I mean it, Teresa. If you do anything, anything at all, to ruin today, I will kill you myself.
What can I say but sit back and enjoy the show?